was thumbing through the want ads in the Shelby County Tribune when this classified advertisement caught my eye. It said, take immediate delivery on this 57 Chevrolet half-ton pickup truck. We'll sell or swap for a hide a bed and $35. Call 140-RING-2 and ask for Bob. Well, I called Bob up on the telephone. He says, hello, this is Bob speaking. I says, this here the Bob got the pickup truck for sale? He says, yeah. I says, where are you? He says, 14 East on County 12. Turn right on the one-lane gravel road. You can park in the yard. Beware of the dog. Wipe your feet off, knock three times, and bring your billfold. Well, I tooled on East on County 12, turned right on the one-lane gravel road, and I parked in the yard, and a German Shepherd come out and grabbed onto my leg. Then I knocked three times to wipe my feet. The dog let go, and the screen door opened. Bob come out and says, what do you want? Says, come see your truck. He says, follow me. Come on, Frank. Dog's name is Frank. Well, we all went past the chicken house, through the hog pen, down to the tractor shed, and then wound up back of the barn field of cow pies. And sitting right there in a pool of grease was a half-ton Chevy pickup truck with a 1960 license plate, a bumper sticker says Vote for Dick, and a Brillo box full of rusty parts. And Bob says, what do you think? Well, I kicked the tire and then got in the seat and sat on a petrified apple core and found a bunch of field mice living in the glove compartment. He says their shaft is bent and the rear end leaks. You can fix her quick with an oily rag. Use a nail starter. I lost the key. Don't pay any mind to that whirring sound. She used a little oil, but outside of that, she cherry. I says, what'll it take? Says, what do you got? I says, $28.15. Says, you got a deal sign here. I'll go get the title and the can full of gas. I put a nail in the slot and fired her up. She coughed and belched up a bunch of smoke, and I backed her right through the hog pen into the yard. Well, Frank jumped in and bit my leg, and I beat him off the crowbar. He jumped on out, and the door fell off, and the left front tire went flat. I jacked it up and patched the tube, and Frank tore a piece of my shirt off. And then Bob come out and called him off, says, you better get on out of here. I went left on the one-lane gravel road, went 14 west in County 12, took two full quarts of 40-weight oil, just get her to the Conoco station. And I pulled up to the regular pump, and then Harold Sykes and his kid come out and says, I'd seen better stuff at the junkyard, and where'd you ever get that truck? I said, that's a long story, Harold. I was thumbing through the want ads in the Shelby County Tribune when this classified advertisement caught my eye. It said take immediate delivery on the 57 Chevrolet. We was screaming through the valley where the nation of botany flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across the railroad tracks of Persia, down the hills and up the dale, at CJ5 of the four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Well, he picked me up at exit 12 on the I-680 ramp. I was doing 67 per when I rumbled through his trap. He commenced to whirl his flashing lights and he made his siren wail. I slipped on down to four-wheel drive with Smokey on my tail. Now I got racing stripes and dual pipes and Smokey's got a Ford. Got a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, but Smokey stroked and bored. Well, the chase was on, but I had the edge with a rig that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 with a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Yeah, he was. Well, I dropped on down at Granny Low and I made a hard right turn. My big old fat commando tires went slicing through the corn. Well, the tassels blew and the kernels flew and it looked like yellow hail. Just cooking alive in a four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Well, we went screaming through the valley where the nation of botany flows, through the mud and crud and cornfields where the marijuana grows, across the railroad tracks of Persia, up the hills and down the dales. My CJ5 and four-wheel drive, Smokey on my tail. Look out now, here he comes. Oh, we gonna get it on now. Don't hit that fellow with a banjo. We gonna swim this here creek now, Smokey. Yard wide and foot deep. Nation of Botany River, they call it. Might have to winch out. Gonna do a wheelie on that there gopher mound now, Smokey. Can you dig it, Smokey? Got four on the floor and four in the air on that one, didn't we? Goodness gracious. Like to bust my shocks. Well, that Jeep of mine made Smokey whine. His rig was made of lead. He's mired in 14 feet of mud, so he radioed ahead. I pulled up onto the blacktop and went crashing on through the rail. sakes alive, I had 25 more Smokies on my tail. Now I had racing stripes and dual pipes, and Smokey had a Ford. Had a mill with a four-pot carb, you know, but Smokey's stroking bored. Well, the race is on, but I had the edge with a rig that'll never fail. Got a CJ5 with a four-wheel drive setting out back of the jail. Me and RJ and the kids was on a camp out in the mountains, and we had us one of them U-Drive Marmy Jeep cars, which we'd rented from a fella by the name of Q Bosky for $30 a day. Buy your gas along the way, take a rabbit's foot, and leave a pint of blood for a deposit. And he explained it all to us, how we were supposed to get to Telluride, which is 50 miles away by way of the regular highway. However, there was a shortcut, but unless we had drove the Black Bear Road before, we'd better be off to stay in bed, sleep late. Pay no attention to the guitar there. Well, we took up off on the highway, and we come upon a sign that says, Black Bear Road, you don't have to be crazy to drive this road, but it helps. I says, RJ, this must be the shortcut road Kubowski's talking about. She didn't pay no mind, because she was making peanut butter sandwiches for the kids in the back seat, throwing rocks and drinking Kool-Aid and playing count the license plates. But they wasn't having too much fun accounting the license plate or cars, because there weren't no other cars. We went about a mile and a half, about 4 hours, busted off the right front fender, tore a hole in the oil pan on rocks big as a hall closet, went over a bump, spilt the Kool-Aid, and Roy Jean stuck his bolo knife right through the convertible top, and the dog threw up all over the back seat. Peanut butter don't agree with me, see. So we had to stop, take off the top, and air everything out, clean it up. The dog run off, and RJ says she felt her asthma coming on. I was sitting there wondering what to do, when the entire scenic San Juan, you drive a Marmy Jeep car, sank in the mud at 13,000 feet above sea level. Well, we shoveled it out and ate our lunch. Dog made a yellow hole in the snow, and Roy Jean got out his Instamatic and took a snapshot of it. Mary Elizabeth drew a picture of the road. It looked like a whole bunch of Z's and W's all strung together. And RJ took one look at it and said the only way that Jeep car is going down that road is over her dead body. Then a rock slipped off from under the wheel, and the U-Drive Marmy Jeep car went right over the edge of a cliff. Doggone it, Roy Jean. How many times do I have to explain it to you? When I tell you to put a rock under the wheel, I mean rock. Now look at that, what you'd have there, no bigger grapefruit.